Hey everybody, it's Laz. I got brand new, awesome news for you guys. I'm using a new simulator, which is called EVE-NG for next generation. It is very similar to GNS3. All right, now the base of it is Linux. You gotta do a couple things here and there to get it working. But once you get it up and running, because you're gonna need VMware Player, it runs on top of that. It is a web GUI interface because you have to type in an IP address and you get in. But it's a very user-friendly simulator, all right? And I'm gonna leave you with a lab just to show you the very basic lab that we can do. And it looks just like, well, not just like, but it acts just like GNS3. But man, can you, all the commands are there. All the commands are there for this particular simulator. So we're gonna be using this. I don't have the image for the switch yet. So if I do any kind of switch configurations, it will be in the packet tracer. But once I get the image for the switch, I'll pop it in there, and then we'll do everything on EVE-NG. I'm really in love with this simulator. It's really easy to work with, not a big deal. But a big shout out to David Bumball. It is because of him that I learned about EVE-NG, okay? Because he has a YouTube video that talks about how to install EVE-NG. He does a very excellent job as usual. All right, he's brilliant. So if you wanna look on how the installation process and how to get it done, definitely you wanna go to David Bumball's YouTube and take a look at that video, very good. But I installed it without any pain. It installed right away. I did everything. I uploaded the image. Everything worked just fine, okay? But again, this is a new simulator. I'm gonna leave you with a routing lab, just three routers, three computers. We'll be configuring RIP, just so you can see how simple EVE-NG is. Now they do have PDF, they call them cookbooks, all right? And it's telling you exactly how to do whatever you want, step by step. They got FAQs, they got documentation, I mean the page is eve-ng.org, all right? Just go there. You can just Google eve-ng and it'll pop up. And you're gonna see tons of documentation within that website that will help you to do whatever it is that you need to do, okay? But enough about that. Let's get into the lab. I wish you all the best and I'll see you later. Welcome everybody, Laz here. Here we are in a brand new simulator that I've configured. It's called EVE-NG. The NG stands for next generation. It's very similar to GNS3, but it's not the same, obviously. It is a little bit different. There's many different ways of navigating through it and stuff like that. But just to show you that me, Laz, is moving forward to using EVE-NG for the majority of the configurations. And just to show you how it's done, one of the things is that, because this is actually on a on the internet. This is, you go to a particular IP address that you're given after you've configured several things, okay? And you log in and you're in this EVE-NG dashboard where you can create a lab. And I have the image for the routers, and it already comes with virtual PCs, but you have a choice where you can choose either an HTML5 workspace or the native console. I'm using the native console, and the reason why is that I can go ahead and do PuTTY sessions when I log into whatever router, because then within the PuTTY, I can do whatever it is that I want. As we all know, we can just right click, go to the PuTTY and change the font size, change the color, do whatever we need to do and stuff like that. So I'm just gonna show you how simple and easy this is. So I'm gonna click on this one and it says open an SSH or telnet to that client. And you can see that now I'm inside. This is, you see how that has the name R3 right there? And I'm actually inside a computer. So I can just go here, go to change settings, go to behavior, change that to, let's call it what it says right there, VPC, put in caps, VPC 4, right? And click apply. And now we're in VPC4. So let's put an IP address. You can see that the network we're using is something very simple, very basic. So IP, second, it's like, you know, GNS3, 192.168.1.1. 255.255.255.0. Enter. Oh, what did I do wrong? Oh, the gateway. Did I do something wrong? IP. Let me see. Well, let's type help. Show. Oh, that's in capital. Okay. So when we're putting IP, right? So we do. Let's do a IP, and then question mark, and then it shows you here. So it's the same thing as in GNS3. So IP. 192.168.1.1, 255.255.255.0, and then the gateway is 192.168.1.254, or it will be. So then it checks your duplicate addresses. All right, cool. So we have that there. We can do an IP config. What do they want? Back command. Oh. Let's see. There is no IP. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. That's right. Oops. Show IP. There it is. Show IP. Sorry. I forgot I was in a computer, not a router. Show commands on an IP. Cool. But hey, it's a pretty cool simulator. I like it. So there's our IP address and our gateway. All right. So we will minimize this and we'll get into this. Right. You can right click on it. All right. As well. You know, if you want to stop it, do whatever. Or you can just click on it. Sometimes it gets a little whatever. So you keep on clicking to get this little session right here. Let's bring this down. You see it says R3 again. This is not R3. This is VPC5. Okay, so I'm going to right click the PuTTY icon, go to change settings, go to behavior, and change that to VPC5. VPC5. And then apply it. Now it's VPC5. Take out the caps, IP address. This is a different network, obviously, 192.168.2.1 space 255. Oh, no, gateway. Oh, no, we need a math. 255.255.255.0. Now the gateway. 192.168.2.254. Oh, that's correct. I'm sorry. I just did it. 192.168.2.1/24, 192.168. Oops, my finger in the keyboard last. 168.2.254. Invalid address. Okay, so let's do this again. So, okay, why am I being wrong? IP 192.168.2.1. Oh, sorry. /24. There it is right there in white. And then the gateway, 192.168.2.254. Okay, cool. Now it's working. Let's minimize that. Let me just check this real quick again. And I shouldn't have that session open already. So where's VPC4? There it is. And do I have the correct mask? I don't think I have a mask on there. Oh, yes, I do. Right there, 24. Awesome. So we got the mask and all that. So now we can go ahead and do a console session with the router, all right? So we can right-click the router, okay? I'll just click on the router. We already have the console session open, so you just click on it, and this SSH thing is gonna come up, and now I'm in router one, okay? As you can see right here, I already changed that to router one, and it's awesome. It's the same thing, config T, IP, and what is the interface they're configuring? F10, which is towards the PC. So IP, int F0/1, right? Isn't that correct? Int, wow, that's combining commands, see? Why doesn't the simulator know what I want? Int, really, F-A? Oh, 10, F1/0, whoops. IP address. 192.168.1.254.255.255.255.0. Enter. And then, of course, you know, shut. And then if we go to the other interface, that will be F00. Right? So it'll be int F0/0. Say we get it right this time. IP address. 10.1.1.5, 255.255.255.252 using a set of 30. And we do no shut there as well. Do WR. All right, I'm just going to minimize that. Now I'm going to go into this router here in the middle, which is router 2. All right, and then we can see we have the 10.1.1.4. So, okay. So we have here, let me do this because you can actually move, you select everything, you know, lasso and loop. All right, router 2, here we go, a little better. And then click in there, say enable, conf t, right, int f0/0, IP address, too many S's, 10.1.1.6, 255.255.255.252, enter, no shot, and then go int f1, /0. I'll do it again just to make sure I'm like that. IP address 10.1.1.9, 255.255.255.252. No shut. And then do WR. All right. That's done. Let's minimize that one. And let's go ahead and do this. This guy right here. This is a router 3. Look at our buddy. Router 3. There we are. And again, this is going to be. Where do we move it? Let's do that right there. Okay. So here we go. All right. So F00. We'll just as we go. All right. So enable conf t int F0/0 IP address 10.1.1.10 255.255.255.252 and enter. No shot. So the other one is int f1/0. And again, I'm going to up-arrow just to make sure that I am in there. And that's going to be the 2.54. So IP address 192.168.2.254, 255.255.255.0. And then we're going to do a no shut on that. All right, do WR. So we've configured the IP addresses on all the interfaces. So we can check to see if at least we can get to our gateway. All right, so let's go to VPC5, right? And then let me ping 192.168.2.254. And there's our reply. Always the first is timeout, obviously due to the fact that it's Ethernet, and we get that ARP, right? So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a simple rip. Just to show you, again, playing around with a new simulator, what we can do here is same as, like I said, same or better than GNS3, but it's cool and it's very user-friendly. If I go to router 1, we're just going to do rip, something very simple, no big deal. Let's exit, router, rip version 2, network 10.0.0, classful boundary people, network 192.168.1.0. Cannot forget. New auto summary. Yes. Very good. All right. So let's go over to the middle. That one's pretty easy. It's only one network that we need to advertise. Exit. Router rip version 2. Network 10.0.0. No auto summary. DWR. None. And then the last router. Router 3, we do the same thing, exit, router, rip, version 2, net 10.0.0, and then net 192.168.2.0, no auto summary, enter, do WR, control Z, let's look at our routing table, show IP route, cool! And then you can see that we're learning. Here's rip. Can we ping? Ping, let's say 192.168.2.254. And we can. Look how quick that came back. That was awesome. Let's go into VPC5. Let's see if we can go all the way across. All right. So we're going to do, let's do an up arrow. And let's do .1.1. Oh, we're taking chances now. Look at that. So this is awesome. So this is a brand new simulator. Again, it takes a little bit to configure and to put things in.
but not a big deal. But as you can see here, you can add nodes. All right, you can zoom in. All right, you can do a bunch of things. You can do a bunch of things with this. Yeah, if I click on here, I can create text. That's how I created these IP addresses on here. But one of the things that's pretty cool, if you right click and you do node, this, look at the list. Look at the list of things that you can put. Now, these images obviously are not free. All right, the simulator is, but not the, well, the simulator for community. So you go to eve-ng, okay? And just go search on Google for it, it'll take you to it. All right, it's gonna go ahead and you download the free version of it, which is the community, right? Because it's not for business purposes, right? You're not using it in your business or anything like that. So, but you need to purchase these iOSs. As you can see, this one's in blue. This is what I'm using. If it's grayed out, you can't use it, but you have the possibility. Look at that. Look at all these things that it supports. Whoa, look, Juniper's in there, Linux, MicroTik. Hello. MicroTik router OS. Didn't I have something the other day? An expert talking about MicroTik. Okay, so we have MicroTik right in there. Okay, Palo Alto. We have it in there as well. So there's a bunch of things, and you see this came in by default. So there's a whole bunch of things that you can do with this. All right, just a matter of playing with it and stuff. And it gives you information. So it's not only that we can create these things. If I were to actually go here now and I can close my lab, all right, and so you sure? Oh, that's right, we got to turn off the nodes. It tells you turn off your nodes. Okay, so I'm gonna select them all. I'm gonna right click. I'm gonna stop selected. Stop, stop, stop. Okay, then stop. Let's find it. Let's try it. Close it again. No, okay, so I'll do it one at a time. All right, stop. Okay, stop. It's a brand new simulator. Okay, so will there be bugs? Yeah, okay. It's an online simulator, so give it a break, okay? And let's try to click this one again. There we go. Now I stopped it. Close the lab. Look at this. And as you see, I've been doing playing around with different labs and stuff. You can see I brand new installed it. But what is what's cool about this? You go to system and you go to system status, and it gives you, you know, hey, memory that's being used, processor, nothing that's being used. So you can actually get all these things that are running. You go, you know, they have a main dashboard that you can go ahead and take a look at different things. You can import, export. I mean, you can, you know, toggle the order. You can edit the lab right from here. You can create a new lab from right here. Information about, you know, whatever, GitLab, YouTube channel. So you can get videos on how to use this. Or you can get a chat, a live chat with somebody that will go ahead and help you out. So this is the brand new spanking Eve. You can see it right here. Eve, Eve-N-NG. Take a look at it, all right? So you can, you know, play around with it. This is one of the things. Just wanted to show you. And again, I can open up my lab, all right? You can see it right there. Look how cool it's right there. And I can just click open, or I can delete it or whatever, and there it is. Okay, there it is. So one of the things that I wanted to show you as well. Yeah, let's start it. Come on. Start. Okay, so that's started. And then I'm gonna right click. I'm gonna click on it, sorry. Click, click, come on, click. Oh, it's right here. That's right, I forgot. They're right here. So there's router one. One of the things that I want to show you that wasn't, you know, the connection remote, okay. Let me close that. There you go. I didn't do a new putty session, okay. And enter a couple times. Show, well, let's go to the config. Conf T. I'm just gonna put in the question mark. Look at all this. This wasn't available before, all right. So it does way more than the packet tracer, obviously. Look at all these different commands that are available to us now, so we can do a little bit more real world. And the fact that I'm using PuTTY actually makes it more real world as well. So not only are you gonna be getting a training on your CCNA 200-25, you know, 200-301, whatever it is, all right? But you're also, it'll be more real world in the sense that you'll be playing around with PuTTY as well, okay? And you have all these different commands available to you. Look at that. I just keep sitting at it. If I hit all the way down, look at that. Look at all those commands. They're available to me now that weren't available to me before. All right, so get ready. Everybody knows I got a boot camp coming up October 25th to November 3rd. It's a 40-hour boot camp. I'm going to be using this. When it comes to the switches, I haven't loaded the switch image on here. I'll probably do it in the packet tracer. But for the routers, yeah, we'll be using Eve. Now, just to answer your questions real quick, is can you do what I'm doing here? Whatever I'm going to do here, you'll probably be able to replicate it in packet tracer, in GNS3, in Boson, and whatever it is that you're using, okay? But I urge you, hey, look into this because it really has a lot of new features. It just, look at the videos, download their cookbook for the community because there's different cookbooks. That's what they call them, their help guide, right? Their step-by-step instruction. And it will go ahead and show you how to do things, all right? Step by step. Very easy, not crazy, all right? It's Linux-based. So definitely, I do have my VMware Player, because it's free, VMware Player running, okay? And you load the OVA into VMware, and once that's done and configured, you can go ahead and they give you that IP address. We can log in with the credentials, and you'll boom, be in the dashboard. It's awesome. It's awesome. Take a look at it. I hope to see everybody in that that boot camp. We're going to be learning a lot of things.
All right. We're outside the lab. No big deal. See how simple that was? Now, obviously, I didn't show you how to get to it, but you saw the simulator. You saw the nodes. You saw the capability of all, or the possibility, I should say, of all the different devices that you can use. Obviously, all those operating systems for all those devices, you need to purchase. You need to get your viral images, whatever the case is. All right, you need to purchase that. But everything else is right there. By default, it has that virtual PC. That's there by default. All I did was just put up the image for that particular router that I'm using. And we're doing putty sessions. We're doing putty sessions to it, which is pretty cool. One thing I want to remind everybody, clock is ticking. Clock is ticking. All right. I have a boot camp on October 25th, all right, to November 3rd. I got to remember that, okay? October 3rd, it's written right there. October 25th to November 3rd, okay, which is 4 hours for 10 days. So it's a 40-hour boot camp. This is for the CCNA 200-125. And I want to reemphasize, get your CCNA now. Okay, get your CCNA now. So you have 3 whole years, all right, to get ready for the new CCNP, all right, which is 2 tests, core and then a concentration. All right, so get it now. Don't waste time because now it's easy. Now it's not a big deal. Once February 24th comes around, you're done. Now you got to take the new one. I mean, I am creating a course on globed.net, all right, which I'm publishing as I go. But you need to make sure that I'm telling you, get it now. That way you get it out of the way. You're already CCNA certified. All you need to worry about now is your CCNP because you're not stopping at CCNA. You are continuing to CCNP. And if all goes well, CCIE. All right, you need to keep growing. You need to keep growing. All right, but again, October 25th to November 3rd, all right, it's going to start at 6 p.m. my time, Eastern time. Sign up for the bootcamp. Sign up for the bootcamp because it's going to be beneficial to your IT career if you're doing Cisco. Or even just an IT person in the business place. There's routers and switches in there. All right, so it behooves you to sign up for this bootcamp. That way you can have me there live, ask questions. I'm going to be giving you tons of labs, and you'll know how to configure whatever it is that you need to do to configure. Okay? So with that said, I'll leave you. I wish you all the best. I'll see you soon.